तो मेजर संदीप का perhaps उनका ऐसा फिलॉसफी था कि पेट्रियोटिक बनना सबका काम है, लेकिन उन पेट्रियट्स की रक्षा करना सोल्जर का काम है. ऑब्वियसली मेकिंग अ फिल्म इंस्पायर्ड बाय मेजर संदीप स्टोरीज, देयर आर रॉयल्टी, व्हाट काइंड, यू नो, आई वाज ट्राइंग टू ब्रिंग दैट अप विदाउट ऑफेंडिंग देम इन सम वे. एंड अंकल, आई रिमेंबर अंकल सेड, अगर एक और बार ये मुझसे पूछा, आई एम गोना किक यू आउट ऑफ माय हाउस. मैंने कहा अंकल क्यों, यू नो, ही सेड, यू नो, यू कांट पुट अ वैल्यू एंड वर्थ टू दीस थिंग्स. Hey guys, this is Arvi Sesh and you're watching Bollywood Hangama.
Sesh, welcome on Bollywood Hangama.
Thank you, Baba. Thank you so much.
How does it feel? Such a grand launch by superstars of the country. How does it feel?
Acha laga hai. Matlab, you know, it's I'm really fortunate that we're dealing with the subject matter. Matlab, Kashmir se leke Kanyakumari tak har jagah ek respect hai film ke liye. So we're getting a lot of support. We're getting a lot of support from the army, obviously from Salman sir, from Mahesh sir, from Prithviraj Chetta, and you know, just to be able to bring it to the people this way is nice.
Okay, and you're basically from Hyderabad?
Yeah, I was born here. I grew up in San Francisco. And strangely enough, मैंने वहाँ पर हिंदी सीखी, क्योंकि वहाँ पे when I was growing up तेलुगु लोग थे ही नहीं, तो जितने भी देसी से बात करना था, मतलब उनको अंग्रेजी नहीं आती थी, so I used to speak to them in Hindi, try and feel a little bit Indian, and then that's how I picked it up.
Now tell us something about your background. So you're saying that you're born in Hyderabad, raised in California. Yeah. And for how many years in California?
A little under 2 decades actually. So you know, basically most of my life was there. And you know, फिर यार वो एक फिल्म का एक बग होता है ना, मतलब फिल्मों में काम करने का मन था. एंड देन आई रिमेंबर माय फर्स्ट फिल्म, देयर वाज अ बिग क्वेश्चन, डिड आई वांट टू मेक इट इन हिंदी और डिड आई वांट टू मेक इट इन तेलुगु. अल्टीमेटली डिसाइड टू गो विद तेलुगु जस्ट बिकॉज यू नो इट्स यू आर केटरिंग टू अ टाइटर ऑडियंस. सो आई डिड दैट एंड यू नो ट्राइंग टू केटर टू ऑल ऑफ इंडिया नाउ विद दिस वन.
इट्स कमिंग इन 3 languages.
जी, मतलब तेलुगु और हिंदी में हमने शूट किया है, पर मलयालम में डब कर रहे हैं. यू नो, इट्स आल्सो सॉर्ट ऑफ अ बिट ऑफ एन इमोशनल रीजन कि हम मलयालम में रिलीज कर रहे हैं. एक तो मेजर संदीप सर के, मतलब उनका मदर टंग है मलयालम, एंड आई जस्ट समवेयर इन माय हेड वाज अ कूल आइडिया कि उनके घर वाले, उनके फैमिली, वो सब उनके मदर टंग में देखे, मतलब फिल्म को, यू नो, इट वाज अ नाइस आइडिया. सो इट्स मोर ऑफ एन इमोशनल रीजन टू डू इट इन मलयालम मोर देन एनीथिंग एल्स.
And did you speak to I'm sure that you must have spoken to his family.
Of course. No, uncle and auntie have become in many ways for me like second parents. You know, every week I speak to them, and every week I'm asking them, matlab Sandeep sir aise kaise honge, matlab wo kaise sochenge, aise situation mein kya karenge wo, because that helps me with my performance. So in many ways the auntie especially, she's a bit of a consultant for me. कि संदीप सर स्पेशली डोमेस्टिक सिचुएशंस में, मतलब हम जानते हैं कि टैक्टिकली वो आर्मी में क्या करेंगे फ्रॉम आवर रिसर्च, पर एक सिंपल सिचुएशन, दोस्त के साथ झगड़ा हो रहा था, मतलब वो कैसे रिएक्ट करेंगे. एंड दैट्स वेयर सॉर्ट ऑफ द एडवाइस ऑफ हिज फ्रेंड्स एंड फैमिली कम्स इनटू प्ले.
ओके, एंड यू नो मेनी अ टाइम्स इट इज द वॉर हीरोज और द आर्मी हीरोज एंड वेरियस डिफेंस फोर्सेस, द हीरोज ऑफ दीस फोर्सेस, they are celebrated and rightly so, but people really don't get to see what their families go through, because there's their life.
That's a huge topic in this film actually. Matlab, in fact it's a direct sentence, it's a direct line. Har koi ye sochta hai ki ye kya karte, koi ye kyun nahi sochta ki unke families ke bhi sacrifices hote hain, you know. It's a very important facet and part of the fabric of this film. Aur uske sath sath there's also the sense of aisa nahi hai ki Indian cricket team ko cheer karna ya aisi cheezon mein deshbhakti nahi hai, wo hai. To major sandeep ka perhaps unka aisa philosophy tha ki patriotic banna sabka kaam hai, lekin un patriots ki raksha karna soldier ka kaam hai. And that's why we ended up using that as the main sort of thematic line in the teaser, that dialogue ki देशभक्ति तो सब में है, मतलब देश से हर कोई प्यार करता है, लेकिन वो पेट्रियट्स, उन पेट्रियट्स की रक्षा करना हमारा काम है, यू नो, दैट्स द जॉब ऑफ अ सोल्जर.
And so talking about the family part of it, once he passed away, a lot was said about him. He was celebrated like anything. Everyone knew his name all across the world. But then we also came to read these reports that, because in the heat of the moment, a lot of these awards are announced and even monetary compensations are announced. Many a times they don't reach the family. And there were those stories that came out with regards to him as well. And the family was disillusioned too. So is that disheartening as someone who
I have to admit, I genuinely don't know too much about that, because when the events and the attacks actually happened, main US mein tha, and that wasn't necessarily part of our research, kyunki matlab ye film ki zindagi ke bare mein. So so much of our time was spent on how he lived, rather than what happened after he passed, and I actually genuinely don't know the answer to your question. and I don't think it'd be fair for me to answer on behalf of the family, of course. But main ye keh sakta hu ki uncle and auntie are, they're the kind of people jo, they don't want anything kisi se bhi. I remember very gingerly bringing up the idea, uncle, auntie, matlab, we're obviously making a film inspired by Major Sandeep's story, is there a royalty? What kind, I was trying to bring that up without offending them in some way. And I remember uncle said, agar ek aur baar ye mujhse pucha, I'm gonna kick you out of my house. Maine kaha, uncle, kyun? He said, you can't put a value and worth to these things, so don't. Let's just do this together. Our whole goal is to make sure people understand who he is and how he lived. And you want to do that too. You want to show that too. So let's do it together. And that's what we're doing.
And you went to his house?
Oh, yeah. like 10 times. Dono jagah, matlab Yalahanka mein unka jo ghar hai, and the museum, aur Bangalore Yalahanka area mein. And at the same time, Whitefield mein jo apartments ko unka naam diya gaya, Sandeep Bihar. And unme ek do apartments unke hain, so unke family ke. So I've been at both places.
Now, anyone, so in any family, I think a lot of people who lose a family member, they would always understand that even though a person is no more, but if you go to their household, he's still there. In their conversations, he's not a was, but he is. That it's like a present tense they use for him, because the memories the way they are and the bonding the way it is, it's going to be there forever. So while you were in the household, did you feel that during the conversations that you had?
Absolutely, absolutely. I still feel it. In fact, so much of our prep has been about getting into this, sort of finding his soul within myself. And when I went into their home, that's what helped. In fact, just as soon as the teaser came out, auntie was saying to me on the phone, it's almost like we were prepared for this, because us zamane mein, selfies or ye digital phones ka concept hi nahi tha. And there's an insane number of photographs and videos of him, like a much higher documentation than a person of that time would have had. NDA mein, Indian Military Academy mein, 7 Bihar, Kargil War mein, 26/11 ke photos, Kolkata Metro training ke photos, all sorts of photographs, just capturing this collage of a life, and letters, hundreds and hundreds of letters, inland letters. So, यही जो आपने पूछा है मतलब यही जो चीजें हैं that determined the fabric of the film, and it really inspired us. And I could tell that he's there now, and he's there for auntie and uncle now, and it inspired me to say, I don't know how much they believe me, but I told them that even after this film is sort of released, I'm with them forever. That's the idea.
When a soldier is preparing for being a commando, obviously it is the most elite commando force in the country. The preparation must be really, really rigorous. So getting into the physicality part of your character, what was your regimen like? How important
was it? That was insane. It was insane, but it was also stop-start. Because in the beach mein pandemic aaya, film ke, after shooting 20% of it, in 9 mahine shooting nahi kar pa rahe the. So it's like, I had this sort of stop-start regime, but the biggest change for me was I'm naturally left-handed. And I don't know if you've seen my film Gudachari, but all of my action scenes and my firing is everything left-handed. So to relearn all the things you've ever done from a right-handed space is insanely tough. And to be able to walk like him, posture, while also doing justice to the idea that he's a military officer and a training officer in the National Security Guard.
And how much time did it take for you to just, you know, for being told that this is the way you need to look and this is the way you need to be and the entire process?
Yeah, told ki to koi baat hi nahi hai. Matlab main khud ka worst critic hoon. Aur you know, main aur director Shashi Kiran Tikka, we've already collaborated on Gudachari before. And so for us, it was just a matter of, I don't know, being true to the story and being true to him. So I lost upwards of 12 kgs for the film. Strict regimen of how army folk live. But to maintain it for a long period of time in the stop-start nature of the pandemic was interesting.
Was interesting. What was your diet regimen like?
Yeah, Rabi, matlab, एक तो इंटरमीटेंट फास्टिंग स्टार्ट कर दिया हमने, यू नो, रोज 12 एक बजे से पहले खाओ ही नहीं, एंड देन फ्रॉम 12 o'clock टू 8 o'clock यू ईट, सो इट्स लाइक अ 16-8, 16 आवर फास्ट, 8 आवर ईटिंग पीरियड. यू डू अबाउट 120 टू 150 ग्राम्स ऑफ प्रोटीन. यू मेक श्योर दैट यू कट आउट एनी प्रोसेस्ड शुगर, यू नो, द नेचर ऑफ द बीस्ट. एंड द बीस्ट आल्सो, यू आर प्लेइंग डिफरेंट एजेस ना, मतलब 20s में, 30s में, तो अलग अलग इराज के लिए अलग अलग लुक्स हैं, हेयर अलग अलग, वेट रिक्वायरमेंट्स हैं, एंड मेनी टाइम्स यू शूटिंग डिफरेंट इराज विद इन अ मंथ, सो दैट वाज इन मेनी वेज, यू नो, अ चैलेंज.
ओके, एंड हाउ इज साई मांझवेकर वर्क
विद? यार, आई कॉल हर द सॉर्ट ऑफ द प्योर emotion on our set, na, matlab ekdam simple, pure hai, bahut, you know, she's very unfiltered and absolutely honest, and that was just a real breath of fresh air, you know, because in the movie business it's very easy to get jaded, na, because many times people might not say what they're really thinking, but she's the kind of person who says exactly what she thinks. So, and that was really good, and I thought she in many ways represents, as you might have seen in the teaser, she represents his past, Major Sandeep's past. Jab wo Frank Andre Public School mein the, part of nostalgia, part of jo already ho hua akal, you know. And Shobhita, on the other hand, represents the tomorrow in the Taj that is about to come into his life. So both women represent two different facets of his life.
And did you interact with Salman? Did you have any interactions? Did you speak to him?
You know, no, actually. My entire, you know, has been through Namrata and, of course, through Sai's family. They've been the ones who've sort of gone ahead and spoken to him, shown him the teaser. And he was very gracious enough to launch it, considering the kind of subject matter we're doing. And that's what I mean, that we're really fortunate that the kind of support we've gotten, everything from army generals to Bollywood superstars, has been immense because of what we're trying to do here.
And what about Mahesh Babu? Because, you know, you are from Hyderabad.
Yeah, so that, you know, that's been a very interesting thing. You know, he's obviously my first audience on everything. I pehle unko teaser dikhaya, story unko, you know, lots of different things about the film are done with his guidance. So he was so gracious that he never got involved on a creative level, but would always listen to our creative ideas and then advise us on how to take it to the next level, how to amplify it to the next level. Especially because, you know, this is not just a Telugu film, it's also a Hindi film. And now it's also a Malayalam film.
Of course. All right, now, living in US for most parts of your life, what was your preparation like for being in Indian movies?
Yeah, Ravi, you know, I've been here for about 9, so it's not like, you know, I'm not sure I remember too much of it, really. And as far as the prep was concerned, it was my childhood, really, in the US. A lot of dreams, you know, hum to wo NRA wale the na, matlab jo Shah Rukh Khan ke jo films dekh ke hum sochte the, yaar, are, you know, how, that's how India is, you know, and it's very different once you get over here. So that was quite a culture shock for me. What I saw of India in Kuch Kuch Hota and Kabhi Kushi Kabhi Gham was not the India that I encountered when I came. So that was quite interesting. But, you know, it's been a few years here, and I guess, you know, it's been a nice run. My film Kshanam was remade by Sajid Sir as Baghi 2 in Hindi. You know, we're taking the Gudachari franchise into Hindi. So just, you know, lots of nice things that have happened to me in Telugu cinema has sort of enabled and paved the way for me to do Hindi film.
So do you have relatives in the film industry, Telugu film industry? Do you have, because, you know, why I'm saying it is that many a times it is within India, there are lakhs of people, lakhs of youngsters who would want to get into the film industry, and they prepare for it, and you know, they have all the they watch all the films which are coming in, for example, in Telugu or say South generally, Malayalam and Tamil, people of Kannada as well. The audience is absolutely crazy the way they follow their stars. But someone who's not living in India and you know, yet getting into the film industry, so that must be like quite a story for many.
It is. You know, I'm actually fortunate that I'm at least for the first couple of years of my career that I was able to take dollars and sort of spend in rupees, no? पर मैं ये सोचता हूँ यार कोई बिहार से हुआ है तो क्या कहीं मतलब लखनऊ से आ गया उनको फिल्मों में काम करना है बिकम्स इवन टफर यू नो एटलीस्ट आई डिडंट हैव अ फाइनेंशियल इशू नेसेसरली एज़ सून एज़ आई केम बट आई एब्सोल्युटली न्यू नोबडी यू नो इट लिटरली स्टार्टेड विद यार ट्रेड गाइड खोलो और देखो कौन से स्टूडियोज हैं अच्छा ए फॉर अन्नपूर्णा आर फॉर रामा नायडू ऐसा स्टूडियोज का नाम पढ़ के मैं गया लाइक दैट्स हाउ माई जर्नी स्टार्टेड यू नो देयर वाज नो सेंस ऑफ नोइंग एनीबडी There's no godfathers. And I feel so fortunate that at least in Telugu film, my work has been so recognized. You know, Bunny's a friend and he was the first one, you know, Kshanam was the first film he ever tweeted about. That wasn't his, you know, because he just came forward and said, I love this movie. Mahesh sir is producing.
Bunny is Mahesh Babu, right?
No, Bunny is Alu Arjun.
Of course.
And Mahesh sir was so gracious to produce this film and sort of take it. You know, it was Namrata Garu's idea to sort of make this a pan-Indian film.
Namrata Shirodkar.
Namrata Shirodkar, yeah. Mahesh sir's wife and obviously a very good actress in her own right and the producer of our film. So many people from the movie business have extended their support to us. इसलिए सिर्फ इसलिए क्योंकि हम जो काम कर रहे हैं वो जेन्यून है वो हार्टफेल्ट है वो ऑनेस्ट है मतलब कोई प्रिटेंशंस नहीं है मतलब हम पॉपुलैरिटी के लिए नहीं कर रहे हैं मतलब वी एक्चुअली वी इंटरेस्टेड इन द आर्ट वी इंटरेस्टेड इन द स्टोरीज वी इंटरेस्टेड इन जस्ट मेकिंग ग्रेट मूवीज यू नो
राइट ओके नाउ बिकॉज़ ऑफ द पेंडेमिक यू नो वी आर एक्सपीरियंसिंग अ वेरी द होल वर्ल्ड इज एक्सपीरियंसिंग अ कंप्लीट टर्न अराउंड व्हेन इट कम्स टू द कंजम्पशन ऑफ एंटरटेनमेंट सो हाउ डू लुक एट दिस force sort of in a way division between cinema halls and OTT platforms and television because we're hoping that cinema halls will open up finally but it doesn't seem like it
is Telugu film is booming na matlab December se leke ab tak we've had like 9 films that have made a profit So our films have been doing very well. So it's a little bit of a different atmosphere. In fact, the pandemic's only catching up to us now in terms of cinema ke hall jana hai ki ab sab sochne lage hain. But until about 2 weeks ago, we were, you know, it was a very different story. There's no question of us wondering whether we're going to a movie theater. The culture of it, and also I think I've said it in an interview too. Matlab jo Punjabiyon ke liye bhangra hai na, Telugu logon ke liye films hai. So.
Telugu, Malayalam, Tamil, all of them.
Absolutely.
Kannada, all of them.
Yeah.
You know, the sort of response that Master has received in Kerala is madness. I've seen videos. It is absolutely, like it's a Tamil film and in Kerala, it's people have gone crazy, absolutely. So, even Vakil, I think Vakil Saab has got like an insane sort of response.
Yeah, it's made 75 crore share, you know, so that should tell you, you know, where we are. But you know, I will say this. I think it's for us. There's no question of cinema being anything other than theatrical. And Major, as evidenced from the teaser, is made for the big screen. It's been designed for the big screen. Had I been wanting to make that film for a streaming service, I would have made it very differently. I wrote the film, so I would have written it differently, and Shashi would have directed it differently. So this is made for the big screen. So whenever, you know, we are able to have both our Hindi, Telugu, and Malayalam version, all three versions released in theaters, is when we come out.
Okay, all right. Now, when you're writing, when you're writing something, you're talking about the screenplay part. How do you relate to the languages within India, be it Telugu or Hindi?
I guess I think in English. So, क्या हो जाता है कि मतलब मेरे जो गुरु हैं तेलुगु फिल्मों में अब्बूरी रवि सर, he's written so many blockbuster films, so he guides me on the dialogue. And we, for Major, what we did is we had someone else write the Hindi dialogue, someone named Akshat, this young upcoming cat, write the Hindi dialogue. So it was this sort of nice back and forth. Sometimes I'd have this great dialogue in Telugu and it won't translate necessarily into Hindi, and Akshat would suggest something else which would be even better than the Telugu version. So we'd actually take that and bring it back into Telugu. So we had that very interesting dynamic. Obviously, the screenplay is in English, so that's how I write.
Okay, now would you want to share your thoughts on screenplay writing? Because many people have this misnomer, this misconception that writing is all about dialogues, but it is much more than that.
हाँ मतलब यार, I don't know if I'm that good that I can say exactly what screenplay should all be about. But the idea being, ultimately we're all storytellers sitting around a fire, just telling stories. That's what we are. So hamari ye koshish hai ki whatever's happening, screenplay ka literal matlab ye hai whatever is playing on screen. That's why it's called a screenplay. So jo kuch bhi chal raha hai, it should keep engaging the audience on a micro level. Everything from the movement of the guy's hand to how he moves to how the girl bounces a particular ball in a tennis game that's being captured, it has to engage the audience. So my interest in screenplay is always about how do we keep the film moving in a way that it engages you. It could make you laugh, it could make you cry, it could make, ultimately has to make you feel, you know. And that's all for me screenplay is. You know, you take this original idea that you have for a story, and then you start thinking about how should it play in each scene.
Right now, having lived in US for a long time, I'm sure that you must have imbibed a lot of the discipline that Hollywood has in terms of screenplay writing or the way they approach their movies. And when you're coming to a very different world of say the Indian cinema, say if you talk about primarily masala films or any films whatsoever, the way they're made in India. The way they approach the screenplay in many ways is much different because the audience is much different. So how did you blend both the worlds?
You know, I actually struggled with that the first couple of years of my career. It took about 4 years for me to get my first, not four, five. It took 5 years for me to get my first success as sort of this hero in Telugu film. Because I wrote my own stories, and when I first came here, I was too American. तो क्या हो जाता था मतलब लोगों को मेरे फिल्म्स एलियन लगते थे, मैं जिस तरह से सोचता था वो एलियन लगता था, एंड देर वॉज दैट इश्यू. सो व्हाट आई रियलाइज इज इमोशनली आई हैव टू थिंक इंडियन, बट प्रैक्टिकली आई हैव टू, द टेक्निकलिटीज हैव टू बी अ वेरी अमेरिकन अप्रोच. दैट्स व्हाट आई डिड विद इट. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल मतलब यार एक समझ लो, एक फ्यूनरल का सीन है. यूएस में क्या होता है, लोग ब्लैक क्लोथ्स पहनते हैं, सनग्लासेस लगा लेते हैं, एंड देर हाइडिंग देयर टीयर्स. अमेरिकन फ्यूनरल में, इंडियन फ्यूनरल एस्पेशली अ साउथ इंडियन फ्यूनरल, लोग व्हाइट क्लोथ्स पहने हैं एंड औरतें जोर जोर से रो रही हैं. द वेरी डेफिनेशन कि हम ग्रीफ कैसे दिखाते हैं फिल्मों में, फॉरगेट फिल्मों में, कल्चरली हम ग्रीफ फील जैसे करते हैं, दैट्स वेरी डिफरेंट. तो इट वॉज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर मी टू मेक श्योर दैट द इमोशनल कॉन्टेंट ऑफ ईच सीन टचेज द हार्ट ऑफ एन इंडियन पर्सन.
एब्सोल्युटली. सो गिव मी अ फ्यू एग्जांपल्स ऑफ योर फेवरेट से हॉलीवुड फिल्म्स एंड फिल्म्स दैट यू रियली लाइक इन तेलुगु एंड हिंदी.
यू नो, आई फॉर मी द प्रेस्टीज इज प्रोबब्ली द परफेक्ट डेफिनेशन ऑफ अ सॉर्ट ऑफ अ परफेक्ट स्क्रीन प्ले. द प्रेस्टीज, ऑल द प्रेसिडेंट्स मैन विद रॉबर्ट रेडफोर्ड, द इनसाइडर विद अल पचिनो एंड रसेल क्रो, I think, and obviously everyone's favorite, The Dark Knight. You know, that's a bit of a cliche to say the Dark Knight or The Godfather, but these are my sort of top five. I've probably seen the Hindi film Rangila about 47 times. Okay. I think in many ways, Rangila, it's a beautiful fantasy. Just the way say every scene works. I think there's one scene in that entire film that didn't work for me. But every scene has a purpose. The way it plays, each scene is either super funny, super musical, or super dramatic. I think it's the definition of sort of Bollywood fantasy in many ways. And I'm a major Aamir Khan fan, so I remember way back when I was a kid, the year 1995, you know, it was this big sort of competition, you know, DDLJ ke awards the or Rangila ke awards the. And I was strictly in the Rangila camp, you know.
I spoke to Ram Gopal Verma a few days back, a few months back, and he was very, very critical of Rangila. He was extremely critical of Rangila, and he told me so many flaws in the film, and I was like, who can do that? But he can do that. Ram Gopal Verma, it doesn't surprise you.
Maybe, I don't know.
So you've told, have you, he's a major Telugu film buff as well. Have you met Ram Gopal Verma? Have you told him about Rangila?
He's offered me a few films, but I never got around to working with him. You know, all Telugu people at some point grew up on Verma sir's films when they were kids. You know, I remember showing the movie Company in my class to all of my American friends. ये दिखाने के लिए कि क्योंकि उस time में थोड़े Indian films थोड़े cheesy हुआ करते थे मतलब cutting edge नहीं हुआ करते थे ना. So as this young boy, for me to show that Indian films भी काफी stylish हो सकते हैं. I remember showing the movie Company to all of my American friends. देखा हम भी stylish films बना सकते हैं करके. I remember showing Company. This beautiful scene where Vivek Oberoi is arguing with Ajay Devgan about how he wants to kill this guy. Ajay Devgan is just thinking, बहुत casually बोल देते हैं, मार दे, and he walks off. That scene, I remember the entire class exploding, like cheering when they saw that scene in my American classroom, my World Cinema class.
World Cinema classroom. Tell us those experiences. How crucial have they been in shaping you, where you are becoming?
You know, I have to admit, it's so interesting to actually think about this, because this is the first interview I've ever done where somebody's asked me about my American upbringing. Because all of my Telugu interviews and a lot of my Hindi interviews have been about sort of yahan aane ke baad kya hua. So that's it's interesting that you're asking me that. I think what I realized is the approach to film is very different in the States versus here in one singular point. Wahan par kya hota hai? Because the English market is so vast, log sochte hain, you make what you want to make, it will find an audience. That's the independent movie approach, indie film, Sundance film approach to filmmaking. And I never got around to being part of the studio sector in Hollywood. You know, I was never on a Marvel set. I was only on the indie film sets. And mera ye manna, when I came here, it is, a lot of people think reverse. Matlab, what does the audience want? Aur usme se hum kya bana sakte hain? And for me, that blend was actually something in between the two. I decided, what do I like? What kind of a story do I want to tell? And then I also ask, does the audience like it?
Of course.
So that's kind of, I try to find that middle ground.
All right, Sesh, lovely talking to you. Thank you very much for your time. And congratulations for the great response to the trailer.
Thank you.
I'm sure that it's going to be a huge success. As well, and I hope that the situation improves soon and it releases in theaters. So all the best for that, and all the best wishes for all your future ventures. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Hey guys, this is Advi Sesh and you're watching Bollywood Hangama.